Hello friends, today we will discuss about p-n junction. P-type semiconductor और n-type semiconductor को जब हम mix करेंगे by heating at high temperature or by another method, then we will find p-n junction. So the diagram of p-n junction can be formed here in this way. So you can say that you can see the diagram of p-n junction. We are going to draw the diagram. If this side is P side or this side is N side, if this is P side, left side is P side, then there will be majority charge carriers. What will be there majority charge carriers? Hole. So let's, these are the holes which are majority charge carriers. These are the holes. So these are the holes whose nature is positive. So these ions, immobile ions, will be negative. Holes are positive, so immobile ions will be negative. Now this one is negative ion. Now this side is N side. So N side means majority charge electrons are the majority charge carriers. So this is electron, this is electron, this is electron, and this is also electron. So these electrons are negatively charged, so immobile ion will be opposite in nature. This is electron, these are the electrons, these are the holes. Holes, nature of hole is positive, nature of electron is negative. So immobile ion will be in opposite nature. This is majority charge carrier, these are the majority charge carriers, so immobile ion will be positive. These are the positive ions. These are the positive ions. Now this is also positive ion. Now this is the region where these are the free charge carriers deplete each other, they destroy each other, they recombine and they destroy each other. So the region, this is the region. You see the region, this one is where free charge carriers deplete each other. What I am to say? This is the region, depletion region. What is it? Depletion layer. A region in which free charge carriers deplete each other, they destroy each other. So this region is known as, that is why this region is known as depletion layer or depletion region. Free charge carriers recombine over and disappear, destroy each other. That is why this is known as depletion region. Now you see, what about the depletion layer? These ions are negatively charged, these ions are the positively charged. These are the immobile ions. So this side become negative and this side become positive. This side become negative, this become positive. So a potential difference is developed here. A potential difference is developed. This is negative, this is positive. So potential difference of depletion layer is known as potential barrier. What is there? VB. VB is potential barrier. Potential barrier. This is potential difference of depletion layer is potential barrier. Now what will happen? These are the holes, these are the electrons, these are the holes, are the electrons are majority charge carriers. These are the majority charge carriers. In N side, and holes are the holes. These are the majority charge carriers. positive side, in p side, electron will be minus charge carriers, and in n side, hole will be minus charge carriers. So the side which is known as p, and the side another side is known as n. So in p side, holes will be majority charge carriers. In n side, electron will be negative, will be positive majority charge carriers. In p sides, electrons are the negative, f electron will be there. So electron will be minus charge carriers, and in n side hole will be minus charge carriers. And the region in which majority charge carrier deplete each other, destroy each other, the region is known as depletion region. And one side of depletion layer become negatively, another side become positively because of the accumulation of negative and positive ions. And due to this reason, there is a potential difference developed in the depletion region. So this potential difference is known as potential barrier. So we got to know p side, n side, then we combine them, then what will be there, depletion region will be prepared, and there will be potential barrier of the depletion region. So now what will be its symbol of the p-n junction? Symbol. Make a triangle and a single line. Draw the symbol in this way. N circle is not so important. This triangle and this vertical line, combination of triangle and vertical line is symbol of p-n junction. This triangle represent positive side and this line represent negative side. This is the symbol of p-n junction, p-n diode. This is the symbol. Now, we will study about forward biasing and reverse biasing of p-n junction. Now, this is the structural diagram of p-n junction, and this is symbol of the p-n junction. So while studying forward biasing, we will use the symbolic diagram. Okay, draw the symbol. This is p-n junction. Now understand this diagram very carefully. If we join positive side of diode with positive side of battery, variable voltage. In this way, suppose that if we join in this way, this simple circuit is forward biasing, but this circuit do not serve our purpose. That is why what we need to measure value of current as well as value of potential difference or value of voltage. So what change will be there? We will connect ammeter and voltmeter, and you know that ammeter is always connected in series, voltmeter is always connected in parallel. So connect ammeter is connected here. Ammeter. Now this is negative of the battery, so this terminal of the ammeter will be negative, another terminal will be positive. Now what about voltmeter? We will join voltmeter here. Voltmeter can be joined at two places. Voltmeter can be connected parallel to diode or parallel to variable voltage. This is variable. इसकी वैल्यू चेंज होती रहती है, इसको हम चेंज करते हैं, नॉब होती है स्ट्रक्चर के अंदर, वहां से घुमा के हम चेंज करते हैं. सो दिस इज वेरिएबल वोल्टेज. सो वी कैन कनेक्ट वोल्टमीटर हियर और इफ यू डू नॉट वांट टू कनेक्ट हियर, इन प्रैक्टिकल वी कनेक्ट इट पैरेलल टू वेरिएबल वोल्टेज बैटरी. वी कनेक्ट टू बैटरी. So now again, positive negative terminal, how will decide positive negative terminal? This side is connected here from positive terminal of the cell. So this side is positive, another side will be negative. This is voltmeter, this is ammeter. This ammeter measures current of milliampere. This ammeter measures the current of milliampere. Now what will happen here? This is the structural diagram. This is the structural diagram forward biasing. So you see this positive side, this is negative side. This is positive side, this is negative side. This positive side is connected with positive terminal of the battery. And this negative side is connected with negative terminal of the battery. So the holes will be pushed towards the depletion layer, and these electrons will be pushed towards the depletion layer. Holes and electrons are pushed in such a way that width of depletion layer will become decreased. Width of depletion layer is decreased. Because width is decreased, so number of negative and positive ions will also be decreased. Therefore, potential barrier of the depletion layer will be decreased. So, in forward biasing, what will happen? Width of depletion layer is decreased as well as potential barrier is decreased. What happened there? Depletion layer width and potential barrier both are decreased. Both are decreased. Dono dikki value decrease ho jati isme. Now we will see IV characteristic in forward biasing. I stand for current and V stand for voltage. So IV characteristic kaisi hogi iske andar, we will draw it. This is, these two are decreased. Remember this thing. The question is asked in the, generally it is asked in the exam directly, what effect will be there on potential barrier and width of differential layer when the PN junction is connected in forward biasing. What will be effect? So direct question pushed here se. We can reply the answer according to this concept. Now what will be IV characteristic? It will be in this way. In this side, there will be current. Its value is in milliampere. Current will be in milliampere order. And in this way, in this x-axis, on this x-axis, we will take voltage. So when we draw the diagram, we find that for some values of voltage, there is value of current zero. For some values of voltage, for some values of V, in this way, for this value, current is 0, for this value, current is 0, for this value. When we do practicals, we find the this graph exactly, we find it. For after some time, we find that value of current is just appeared. Value of current is just appeared. So the value of current, or the value of voltage at which current is appeared, the value of positive voltage at which current is appeared, that value is known as knee voltage. This voltage is known as knee voltage. The value of voltage at which current appears is known as knee voltage, or cut in voltage, or third name is also there, threshold voltage. Threshold voltage. It, what does it mean? Threshold voltage. The term threshold comes in previous chapters also. Threshold frequency was the term there. Threshold means the minimum value of the minimum value. If we use the value less than this value, then no effect will be there. In this case, if we take less value of voltage than the knee voltage, then there will be no current in the PN junction. So this minimum value is known as threshold current or cut-in voltage, this, or it is also known as knee voltage. Now what will be there? Another term will be there, dynamic resistance. Dynamic resistance. Why it is known as dynamic? In case of Ohm's law, the resistance is fixed, so that is known as static resistance. But in case of PN junction, value of resistance is not fixed, it changes. So that is why it is known as dynamic resistance. because value of resistance changes, it is not fixed. That is why it is known as dynamic resistance. Its formula is R D or RFB for dynamic resistance in forward biasing. Its formula is delta V upon delta I. On this graph, you will take any two values of current. For example, in this cell, take these two values. This is I2, this is I1. Now, draw vertical line from here. This corresponding value of I1 is known as value of V1 corresponding to I1 is known as V1, and value of voltage corresponding to I2 is known as V2. Now, if you frame a triangle, form a triangle, this is the triangle. Join this point A, this name this B, this is the triangle ABC. A triangle ABC is from there. Join A to B in this way. This is the triangle ABC. So, in triangle ABC, this is for example theta. So, slope of this curve, dynamic resistance. What is dynamic resistance? Slope of curve. That is tan theta. Or it is V2 minus V1 upon I2 minus I1. So, dynamic resistance is simply, what is there? Frame a triangle using two points on the curve and take corresponding values of currents and voltage. Find out delta V, find out delta I, delta V and delta I, and use the formula dynamic resistance in forward biasing, that is equal to delta V upon delta I. It means V2 minus V1 upon I2 minus I1. Put these values here and we can find out value of dynamic resistance. So this is forward biasing circuit diagram. This is IV matrix in forward biasing. This is dynamic resistance in forward biasing. Now we will study about reverse biasing, effect of reverse biasing on deflection region and potential barrier, and IV characteristics in reverse biasing and dynamic resistance in reverse biasing. Now we will study about reverse biasing. This is reverse biasing. We are going to draw a circuit diagram of reverse biasing. This is PN junction. This is positive side, this is negative side. Now understand how to draw the diagram. If we connect positive side of diode with negative side of battery, this is the battery. If you connect in this way, it is just reverse biasing. Negative, positive and variable battery. This is reverse biasing. But again, I say that this diagram do not serve our purpose. That is why, what are the shortcomings here? Voltage, ammeter and voltmeters are not connected in the circuit. And you know that ammeter is connected always in series. So connect ammeter and connect voltmeter. Now we will connect voltmeter here. Voltmeter here. Now check. This is positive side of the battery. So positive, positive, positive. This is positive of ammeter. So another side is negative. Now this positive comes from this side. So this is positive of the voltmeter and this is negative of the voltmeter. You see, how we will decide that this side will be negative? Check it here. Just we will decide by focusing on battery. This is negative side of battery, so this is going to be negative, 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 negative. This is negative of the voltmeter. Another side will be positive. Now check this ammeter. This is positive side of the cell battery. That is why positive, positive, positive. This is positive side of the ammeter. Now circuit diagram is completed. Ammeter is connected, battery is connected, voltmeter is connected, diode is connected. Now because positive side of the diode is connected with negative side of the battery, that is why it is reverse biasing. Now the value of current which is measured in case of reverse biasing is of the order of microammeter. So value of current is measured in microammeter. Why it is so? Because see here, this one, when it is in reverse biasing, this positive side is connected with negative, negative side is connected with positive. So electrons will go towards the positive terminal of the battery, hole will go towards the negative terminal of the battery, and in this process the depletion layer will be stretched such that its width is increased. Hole will move towards negative terminal of the battery. Electrons will move towards the positive terminal of the battery. So this width, this diffusion layer will be stretched out, stretched away, दूर जाएगी. That is why width, what will be width? Width of depletion layer and potential barrier both are increased. दोनों की वैल्यू बढ़ जाएगी इसमें. Width of depletion layer and value of potential barrier will be increased. Why it is so? Because number of holes and electrons crossing the depletion layer will be decreased. Why they are decreased? Because its width is increased. Electrons move towards the positive terminal of the battery and holes move towards the negative terminal of the battery. So width of the depletion layer will be increased. And when width is increased, number of negative charge carriers and positive charge negative ions and positive ions, which are the immobile ions, their number will be increased in the depletion layer. That is why number of negative positive charges which decide the potential barrier will be increased. So negative ions, mobile ions or positive mobile ions, दोनों का नंबर इंक्रीज होगा तो क्या होगा, हमारा पोटेंशियल बैरियर फॉर रिवर्स बायसिंग में इंक्रीज हो जाएगा. रिवर्स बायसिंग में पोटेंशियल बैरियर इंक्रीज होगा, विड्थ भी इंक्रीज होगा, बोथ विल बी इंक्रीज. ओके, नाउ हाउ द आईवी कैरेक्टरिस्टिक विल बी ड्रॉन हियर. दिस इज आईवी कैरेक्टरिस्टिक. व्हेन वी इंक्रीज नेगेटिव द वैल्यू ऑफ वोल्टेज नेगेटिव साइड इन दिस वे, इट विल बी इन दिस वे. For a particular value of negative voltage, that is called zener voltage. VZ, Z-E-N-E-R, zener voltage, VZ. At this value of current is suddenly increased. Value of current is suddenly increased. So the value of negative voltage at which current of microampere is suddenly increased, that value of voltage is known as zener voltage. Now in this diagram we can also find out dynamic resistance V1, V2. Here it will be I1 and it will be I2. So dynamic resistance will be, the formula will be same. We will write here for RB, dynamic resistance reverse biasing is equal to delta V upon delta I. It will be calculated in the same way which is calculated earlier in forward biasing. Thank you. Have a good day. Thank you so much.